Well, joining me now is the programmer of the Sarajevo Film Festival, Elma Tataragic. Thank you for joining us on Showcase.
Thank you very much for having me.
No problem. So it's the 23rd anniversary of the festival. Tell us a bit about the background and how it's evolved over the years.
Well, we started out, where we came from actually was our war cinema, which we started during the war, and then little by little we formed the film department and started making film programs. And during one of those film programs, which was the review of Locarno Film Festival, which was end of 94, we got the idea of making a film festival in war Sarajevo. So basically the first edition of the festival was during the war in the besieged city. It was not the time when we were thinking about the future at all. We were only thinking about making sure that our citizens, people living with us under siege, get their portion of culture and film during horrible circumstances such as war. And we succeeded, but then of course, film and festival business is very addictive. We got addicted to it and we decided to continue. Of course, years and years went by until we found the real concept for our film festival. What we knew from the beginning was actually that we wanted to focus on the region. We wanted to become the epicenter, the heart for the regional cinema. And basically already during the third and fourth and fifth editions of the festival, we created something very small, which was called the regional program, where we were showing films from our part of the world to a very small audience back in our center, which is the Meeting Point Cinema. And then in 2003, we decided to push this up front. We decided on one side to make the competition program on the red carpet and in that way be number one promotional festival for the films from the region. And on the other side, we decided to create the co-production platform. At that time, it was called the CineLink co-production market, which is today CineLink Industry Days.
So what makes the 23rd Sarajevo Film Festival different from the other years?
Well, first of all, from my point of view, which is totally a programmer's point of view, we have introduced another section in the festival. It is a competition program for the student films. So alongside the feature section, the documentary section, and the short section, we also have the student section, which is very important for us because we felt that there is a need for the students, for the very young ones, to be promoted and to be able to compete for the Heart of Sarajevo Award. So this year we are presenting 13 student films competing for the new award, and that I think is one of the most precious jewels. Of course there are other things which are very important, but I would mention that we have decided to separate the short film programs from different sections in another venue, which we call the House of Shorts. Mm-hmm. It's a beautiful cinema, very small cinema now, filled with young people who are there to present their short films. So basically it's the house not only of the competition student films, but also of the Bosnian student films, of the Bosnian short films and European shorts and different short film section happening. We have also moved the children's program and Teen Arena program to their own venue. Mm. So basically the teenagers and the kids this year have their own space, which I think is very, very important.
So along with the young talents and the other producers that have given their works into the festival, what do you guys look for when choosing the films?
What we really are looking for is to remain a festival of discoveries. This does not necessarily mean that we are looking only and exclusively for first features. We are looking for fresh ideas, we are looking for fresh point of views. And this year it's a nice combination in the competition program, especially in the feature film. I would say it's especially diverse, since we have seven films competing for the four awards, and these seven films are quite different from each other. There are films which are more socially oriented, films are which are more active in that kind of a sense, which are telling the post-transitional stories, which are very specific to the region. But there are also quite interesting films which are total surprises that are coming from the region. One of these films, of course, is Semi Kaplanoglu's film Grain, which is set in a dystopian place, and it's rather a big surprise for our audience and also for us, especially that we have the world premiere of this film. But also other films, like for example the Georgian film Hostages, is an action thriller film, which is also something very new to the region. The Greek film Son of Sophia comes also from the background of fantasy. So the program is quite diverse, which is very beautiful, because the audience is very eager to see the films from the region.
Well, thank you so much for joining us on Showcase today.
Thank you so much for having me.